of chapter number 3, Current Electricity, Kirchhoff's Law. Kirchhoff's Law was given by scientist Gustav Robert Kirchhoff, and he gave two laws. One is KCL and other is KVL. What is the need of these two laws? We will study these laws in detail. We have studied about Ohm's Law. Ohm's Law is applicable for ohmic devices only and not hold good for non-ohmic devices. And the circuit in which only one current and one EMF is there is known as circuit. But if multiple currents and multiple EMFs and or inductor or capacitors are connected in a circuit, then that complex circuit is known as network. In order to find the value of current and EMFs in a network, it is very difficult to find the value of current and EMFs with the help of Ohm's law. So Kirchhoff gave two laws to find the value of current and multiple currents and EMF with the help of Ohm's law. So now let's study some terms related to this network. Just let's know there are how many number of circuit elements are connected in this network. Here there are total number of, these are electrical network circuit elements, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 circuit elements are there. What do you mean by node? When two points are connected with us circuit elements, then this point is known as node. So here it is one node, second node, which is connected with two circuit elements. Here it is connected with circuit elements. Now at this point it is connected with a circuit element. When two points are connected with two or more than two circuit elements, then it is said to be node. So here we can say that there is one node, two node, three, four, and this is five. These are nodes five, because if between two points, if there is no resistance connected, then these nodes are considered as a common node. So this is a common node, this is a common node. We can consider it as another node, because here we can see that this is connected with node number 5. So this is node number 5 and so on. So here total number of nodes are 5. How many junctions are there? Junction is that point where more than 3 or more than 2 elements are connected at a point. So here this is one junction. This is one junction. Here more than 2 circuit elements are connected at a point. This is known as junction, and this is also known as junction. There are two junctions. When two circuit elements are connected at a point, then this is known as node, and when three or more than three elements are connected at a point, then this is known as junction. So we can say that junction can be a node, but node cannot be a junction. Now, how many branches are there in this network? Branches are those in which between two nodes, there should not be any third node connected. Or branch is that path in which the circuit elements are connected in series. So here we can say that this is one node, this is second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seven branches, where the circuit elements are connected in series. What do you mean by mesh? Mesh is a closed loop in which any other loop is not included. So this is 1, 2, and 3. Three closed loops are known as mesh. What do you mean by loop? Loop consists more than one mesh. So here, this is one loop, two loop, and three loops. What do you mean by the term short circuit? Short circuit or circuited or simply shorted. A circuit is said to be short when the resistance between the two nodes is zero. When resistance is zero, then by Ohm's law we know that if resistance is zero, it implies that voltage is equal to zero regardless of current. Thus, if any current is flowing in a circuit but if resistance is zero, it means the voltage present in that path is also zero and the circuit is said to be shorted. So here we can see that there is no resistance present between the two nodes. Thus, the value of resistance in this path is zero. So this is a shorted path. Now, next term is, what do you mean by open circuit? Open circuit is a gap or a break between a circuit. And it occurs when resistance is infinite. And when resistance is infinite, it means that current is zero. That is, from Ohm's law, we can see that I is V by R. And if R is infinity, I is zero. Regardless of any voltage across the conductor. Now let's study about the sign conventions which we use to solve Kirchhoff's law. First, we will study about the polarity of voltage sources. Let us suppose this is a battery is given. Now if we are moving from this terminal to this terminal, then there is a voltage drop because this is at higher potential and this is at lower potential. When therefore the voltage will drop and we will consider it as negative voltage. And if our movement is from negative to positive, then there will be a voltage rise from one terminal to other terminal. Thus, the voltage source would be taken as positive. Here there is a voltage drop. And on moving from negative to positive, the voltage will rise. And there is no effect of direction of current on this voltage sources. Simply we have to take, if we are moving from higher to lower terminal, then we have to take voltage negative, and if we are moving from negative to positive, we have to take our voltage positive. Next sign convention is polarity of a resistor. Let us consider a terminal in which a resistor is connected and the direction of current in that resistor is in this way and the arm movement is also in this direction. Thus, there is always a voltage drop. Thus, the value of voltage is negative, which is equal to minus IR. And if our movement is opposite to the direction of current, then we will take the voltage positive. We will follow these steps while solving the numericals related to Kirchhoff's law. Now, what are the two laws? First is Kirchhoff's current law or Kirchhoff's first law. Kirchhoff's current law, known as KCL, simply current law. Or it is also known as junction rule. According to this law, the algebraic sum of all the currents is equal to zero. Or at the junction, the sum of currents entering into the junction is equal to sum of currents leaving the junction. And the currents which are entering into the junctions are considered as positive, and the currents which are leaving the junctions are considered as negative. Thus, let us suppose there is a point that is where we are considering the value of current that is known as junction. So here, according to the rule, I1 plus I2 is equal to I3 plus I4. Or we can write I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4 is equal to 0. Or summation of all the currents is equal to 0. By this we can say that KCL follows conservation of charge. That is, at any point there is no accumulation of charges, the number of currents entering is equal to number of currents leaving. Now next is KVL. Kirchhoff's second law. Kirchhoff's voltage law. also known as loop rule. According to this law, the algebraic sum of changes in potential around any closed loop is zero. That is, algebraic sum of all the potentials is equal to zero in a closed loop, or it can also be written as sum of all the potential differences is equal to sum of all EMFs. This law is applicable only in closed circuit and it is based on conservation of energy. Because at any point we are not gaining any energy at any point. There is, by just circulating the charges around any closed loop, there is no gain of energy. Thus we can say that it is based on conservation of energy and it is applicable in closed circuit only. But Kirchhoff's first law, that is KCL, is applicable for open and closed loop both. Solve some numericals of NCERT and board exams based on Kirchhoff's law. In this, we have to find the value of current in each branch. This is a network given in which multiple currents and resistances are there. So we have studied earlier that when we are moving from negative to positive direction, then the potential or the voltage will drop. Voltage will rise. Thus, it will be taken as positive. And when we are moving across the resistors in the direction of current, then it is taken as negative. But when we are our movement is opposite to the direction of current, then it is taken as positive. So, first of all, we will consider the mesh and apply KCL and KVL accordingly. Here, consider mesh A, B, C, A and apply KVL on it. Apply KVL on mesh A, B, C, A. We can see that here there is a rise of potential, so we'll take it as positive. Now minus 4I2 in this branch, minus 2I2 plus minus I3 minus 2I3 and it is minus I1 equal to 0. On further solving it, we get tan equal to I1 plus 6I2 plus 2I3. Give it equation number 1. Now consider mesh ADCA and apply KVL. Apply KVL on mesh ADCA. Here also it is rise in potential, so take it 10 minus 4I1 plus 4I2. Now movement is opposite, thus plus 2I2 plus 2I3 minus 2I1. Final equation is minus 10 equal to minus 7I1 plus 6I2 plus 2I3. Give it equation number 2. Now apply KVL on this mesh E, B, C, D, E. E, B, C, T, E. Here also voltage will be positive, then minus 2I2 plus I3 minus 2I2 plus I3 minus I1 equal to 0. And when we will solve it, we get the final equation minus this 5 equal to minus 2I1 plus 4I2 plus 4I3. This is equation number 3. So write all the three equations and on further solving these three equations we will get value of I1, I2 and I3. This is equation number 1. Second, now see by equation number 1 and 2 we can see that here it is 6i2 and 2i3 and 2i3. So if I'll subtract the second equation from first, then both I2 and I3 will be eliminated. So on subtracting, the sign will change. And here we remain with 20 equal to 8i1. Thus, I1 equal to 20 by 8. Or we can write 2.5 ampere. So write value of I1 is 20 by 8 ampere. Similarly, compare equation number 2 and 3. Equation 2 is minus 7i1 plus 6i2 plus 2i3 equal to minus 10 and minus 2i1 plus 4i2 plus 4i3. So in order to eliminate any variable, make them equal by multiplying it with a number. So here we can see that if we multiply this equation by 2 and this equation by 3, we get minus 14i1 plus 12i2 plus 4i3 equal to minus 20 and 6i1 plus 12i2 plus 12i3 equal to 15. Now again subtract it to cancel out this value. Sign will change. So here this value will eliminate and it is equal to 14 minus 14 plus 6, that is minus 8. Minus 8i1 minus 8i3 equal to minus minus, that is minus 35. Substitute in this equation value of 20, I1, so we get minus 8 into 20 by 8 minus 8i3 equal to minus 35. So on solving we get value of I3 equal to 15 by 8. Now as our equation number 1 is tan equal to I1 plus 6i2. This is simple mathematics. You can do it by your own also. 6i2 plus 2i3. Here just substitute the value of I1 and I3 and get the value of I2. So tan equal to I1 plus 6 I2 plus 2 × 15/8. Now on solving we get the value of I2 equal to 5/8. I2 is equal to 5/8 ampere. Now here we have to calculate the value of current in each branch. So in branch AB, current I2 is 5/8. In branch BC, it is I2 plus I3, that is 20/8. I2 plus I3, that is 5/8 plus 15/8, that is 20/8. In branch CD, it is I2 plus I3 minus I1, it is equal to 0. Now in branch AT, I1 is 20/8 minus I2, that is 5/8. So in branch AD it is 15/8. And in branch BE, it is I3, that is 15/8 ampere. So this is how we will solve this numerical. Solve one board numerical. In this, we can see that on apply KCL, I3 can be taken as the sum of I1 and I2. Give it equation number 1. Now consider mesh ABDCA and apply KVL. Here we can see that in the direction of current, the direction of resistor or potential is negative, that is minus 4 I1 minus 2, there is a potential drop, that is minus 2 plus 3 I2, because our movement and direction of current is opposite, that is positive. Now minus plus 3 I2 plus 1 equal to 0, or on further solving it we get minus 4 I1 plus 3 I2 minus I1 minus 1 is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Now consider mesh CDFEC. Apply KVL. On mesh CDFEC, we get equation minus 3 I2 minus 1 minus 2 I3 plus 4 equal to 0. Now we can see that I3 is equal to I1 plus I2. So substitute the value to eliminate this I3. So we get minus 3 I2 minus 2 I1 plus I2 plus 3 equal to 0. Or it can also be written as minus 5 I2 minus 2 I1 plus 3 equal to 0. This is taken as equation number 3. Now from equation number 2 and 3 we can find the value of current. Let's see. Write equation number 2, which is माइनस फोर आई वन प्लस थ्री आई टू माइनस वन इक्वल टू ज़ीरो एंड माइनस टू आई वन माइनस फाइव आई टू प्लस थ्री इक्वल टू ज़ीरो. नाउ वी कैन सी दैट इफ आई विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस इक्वेशन विद टू देन इट विल बिकम फोर. सो द फाइनल इक्वेशन विल बी माइनस फोर आई वन माइनस टेन आई टू प्लस सिक्स इज इक्वल टू ज़ीरो. नाउ सब्ट्रैक्ट इट, चेंज द पोलैरिटी, पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव, इट इज इक्वल टू, इट विल बी कैंसिल आउट एंड इट इज थर्टीन आई टू, थर्टीन आई टू माइनस सेवन. देयरफोर आई टू इज इक्वल टू सेवन बाय थर्टीन. This is our answer. Now similarly find values of I1 and I3. On substituting the values in the equations, we get value of I1 is equal to 2 by 13 ampere and I3 is equal to 9 by 13 ampere. So this is the way to solve the numerical. Now see, next numerical.